guys, welcome Hello. Back to my channel. This is me, Pinky, and
BG, my fiance.
Thank you so much, guys, for supporting my channel and for subscribing and keep following my videos. And today I'm going to share with you one of my hidden secrets, shall I say. Yeah, I have a secret for them, from them. Actually, I've been trying to hide the real score of my health. I've been sick for probably real sick like 3 years ago, but I was diagnosed last 2013 that I have chronic interstitial nephritis. This is hereditary. I got this from my dad. My dad, he died in the same situation with a kidney problem.
Not all of us are nurses, so explain that to them, what that big term that you used was.
Okay, chronic interstitial nephritis. I don't know also.
Aren't you a nurse?
Maybe.
It's got to do with the kidneys.
Maybe. I've been long time in dentistry. I forgot already about medical terms. Well, it's a problem in the kidney. When the doctor told me, actually, my diagnosis now, it's confusing because the nephrologist that started counseling me, he don't believe that I have polycystic. So, polycystic, it means you have a lot of cysts in your kidney. Yeah. Okay, he don't believe that. That's the diagnosis. Actually, that diagnosis was from the first, second doctor who have seen me in 2017. What?
First diagnosis, second diagnosis.
Yeah. The first diagnosis I had when I was first admitted and found out that I have kidney problem, that was way back on 2013 when I was in Dubai. I was admitted in Sulaika Hospital and the nephrologist told me there that I have chronic interstitial nephritis. He even did a biopsy on me and find out if how far the infection created in my kidney, and he found out that I have this infection when I was 5 years old, and it was started to create a scar, and he said that it's too late for me to do some interventions or to do some surgery. And he just told me that I need to wait till my dialysis will be advised, and I need to prepare a fistula.
Fistula.
Mm-hmm.
Show me fistula.
Fistula, this one. If you notice my pictures, my video, and my previous vlog, I have this scar in my arm because of my dialysis. This is the fistula they created for them to have a route in inserting big needles during dialysis sessions.
Yikes.
Okay.
I've seen them.
So, yeah. Yeah, so I tried to actually maintain my diet when they diagnosed me on 2017.
So no fish, no rice?
Yeah, because that is... No, you can have rice. You confuse me about that. You can have rice. But during those times, you are not allowed to eat a lot of protein product.
Or like beef and
peanuts. Yeah, all the dish that will convert it to protein because my creatinine started to arise. And if you eat a lot of protein source food, the byproduct of protein will contribute to increasing your creatinine. So from 2013, I was learned to eat more vegetables, but not literally vegan kind of thing, but because sometimes I also eat fish. I cannot forgive, or I cannot give up fish.
Fish and rice.
Yeah, I cannot give up that
vinegar.
One. And vinegar and lemon.
And lemon, yeah.
So I tried to maintain in that diet. So I was able to prolong the time to start dialysis for 4 years. After 4 years, my creatinine was really waving at me.
So we all have creatinine, right? I mean,
yeah, but it should be zero. The normal creatinine is 0.005, something like that. It shouldn't not reach one.
Okay.
Mine, it reached one. It was started one, and then it become 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2017. That was that.
So it's a natural poison that the body makes, but our kidneys get rid of it because your kidney doesn't function. Mm-hmm. And it builds up. Gotcha. Mm.
Exactly.
I'm learning.
Our kidney are the one excreting all the nitrogenous waste product that our body doesn't need it. So, and then here comes 2017. My creatinine was so high, it reaches to 780. If you, I heard that if you reach to 1000 creatinine, you'll be in coma.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. It happens also with my dad. He was in coma for 2 or 3 weeks, I think more than 5 days, but he was in Grace that time, not in Philippines. Wow. So the doctor decided to do a dialysis, to create a fistula and do dialysis for me, because my total kidney function that time was 8. Why you're playing your eyebrow? You become conscious then.
You're just, you know, talking. I was just looking at myself in the video.
Because guys, if your total function is less than 15%, you need the help of dialysis. So mine was 8%, so I need the help of dialysis. Dialysis actually is not an intervention. It's just a relief from a symptoms. Okay, so symptoms that is arising when my kidney is totally shutting down.
We'll show you what dialysis is like.
Okay, so that's why.
Not pretty.
I've been doing dialysis for past more than 2 years and a half, I think. So today is August, September, yeah. October. So two more months, it's going to be 3 years.
Jeez.
Yeah, I've been doing dialysis for 3 years. It's peritoneal dialysis, not hemodialysis, because I don't like hemodialysis. I'm always confused with peritoneal and hemo.
Don't ask me, I'm not the nurse. I just work at a nuclear power plant.
Peritoneal, hemo.
Hemo is like blood.
No. Hemo is, I think it's the one in the tummy, and peritoneal is the one what I'm having.
In the arm?
Yeah.
Or vice versa.
Just to be sure.
Cover our bases here. It could be one or the other. We're not sure. It's either the stomach or the arm. Para, hemo, abadabadu.
I forgot already. So I don't like actually that my eyes are very itchy. This is one of the symptoms. If you have kidney problem, actually you have very itchy eyelid, and sometimes you will suffer rashes. Oh no, itchiness kind of feeling, but when you scratch it, there's no rashes will appear, right?
Yeah,
and
scratch your back all the time.
For my part, actually, if you want to ask what was my symptoms, how I discover that I have kidney problem, actually it started when I had
I just want to see what I look like with
him. You're ruining monkey vlogging, baby. What was the symptoms that I noticed prior to my first diagnosis? I noticed that I easily get tired. And my BP was so high, and I keep making pee, and especially if I drink soda. Oh, the urge is very fast, but when I'm going to pee, it's just like a drop of urine. But and it's not healthy. I feel discomfort. That's what I noticed. So when I went accidentally to one of the medical center in Dubai, they found that I have high blood pressure. And when they did the blood examination, there they found my creatinine was high. Then I started to have this medication for my high blood and slowing down my creatinine. I tried to control my intake of protein. Then when my creatinine actually reached to more than 700, I realized I started to look pale because my hemoglobin started to slow down. Because as we all know, our kidney is the one main source for our hormone. It's called erythropoietin that is helping to produce hemoglobin. So since my kidney was compromised, my kidneys are able to produce this hormone, it's called erythropoietin, to help my hemoglobin. So my hemoglobin was so down, that's why I was looking pale and I easily get tired.
Okay, for those that don't know, hemoglobin is blood. It's a fancy term for blood. So the kidney helps produce the blood that we need.
Okay. So I was admitted in Mafraq Hospital. This is one of the biggest government hospital here in Abu Dhabi. And the doctor told me that I really need to start dialysis. So I was emergency booked for surgery and creating EV fistula, EV catheter. This is the emergency route for emergency dialysis, not the fistula. So as you can see, I have the scar over here. This is where they inserted the catheter for having an emergency route for dialysis. And it took me a while to remove this because my fistula was very slow in developing the big artery and big vein. It was very slow for me, so I was in catheter for 8 months.
Wow.
And you don't know, guys, I was traveling in Philippines with my catheter hook in it. So when they do dialysis, they are doing it here. They will just connect with the tube.
Yeah.
So I was bringing it in Maspati with this catheter, just trying to live normally, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, there is a misconception to our place, especially in Maspati, because I heard that when they know that I was in dialysis, they were thinking that I would be bedridden and I'm almost in my terminal stage of dying.
Jeez.
Actually, it's not. It's not actually. It depends to the condition of individual. If the individual is super duper old and he has lots of existing diseases or complications, then probably the person will be in terminal stage. But in my case, I'm very young and I don't have any other conditions apart my kidney problem. I'm not diabetic. So it's just like so normal to me. When the nephrologist decided me to create a fistula, they did it here. They connect my artery and my venous to create a fistula. But nothing in it there. Okay, it's just my vein and artery. There's no artificial tubes or whatsoever.
And the reason it looks this way is they continue putting needles into the skin, causing the scarring of the upper portion of the skin.
Yeah, that's the reason, guys. You know,
big needles.
Yeah. Yeah. Actually, my reactions when the doctor told me that I need to do dialysis, it was actually very sad and I was denial. And I don't agree at the beginning. And they tried to convince me that if I will not do it, I will end up into coma. So it seems like I don't have any choice. So I agree with that. But during my first 2 months in dialysis, I was into depression. And I was so sad. And I feel like they took my freedom every Saturday, Monday, and Wednesday because that's the schedule of my dialysis. And it's not only 1 hour, it's a 4 hour session. So every Saturday, Monday, and Wednesday, my 4 hours is not with me. It's for dialysis. So I'm doing that every after my work because I'm working 9 to 5. in my previous company. So after that, I will proceed to my dialysis sessions. So this time during my dialysis, my diet changed. Somehow that is the good part, because before dialysis, I'm not allowed to eat a lot of protein. But during dialysis, my diet changed to increase more protein, because protein somehow is included in excreting during dialysis. So I need to eat a lot of protein, but with minimum or limit intake of fluid. If you are a dialysis patient, you have maintaining weight. It's called dry weight. When you exceed the ton, you will remove it from your body. And I noticed my reaction during dialysis. If they remove a lot of fluid or blood in my body that exceeding to my dry weight, I feel dizzy. Yeah, very dizzy. Especially if I'm from Philippines.
And headaches. You get headaches.
Yeah, that's the complication I'm suffering sometimes when I'm after dialysis. But most of the time, I'm okay after dialysis. So far, I don't experience cramps as the other patients usually experience. And cramps and I don't know. I don't experience fever during dialysis.
Hallucinations?
No. Sometimes you are stubborn during dialysis only. Like your discomfort because there is a big needle in your arm and you cannot move according to what you want. There is a movement restriction because the needle will prick or pass through and through in your veins and it's very painful. I experienced that during my first dialysis. The vein ruptured inside and it's totally painful.
I bet.
I suffered for 2 weeks where I cannot extend my arm, just keep it flexed
like that.
Yeah. Yeah, only like this. I cannot extend. I feel so painful. That was so painful. But you know, I tried to be positive still, because somehow I'm still lucky for those dialysis patients, because in the first place in this country, everything are free. My dialysis is free. When I was admitted in MAFRAC to create this catheter and my fistula, it was all free. So I told myself, why I need to worry? I'm in good hands. I'm in good doctors, good hospitals, and no need for me to worry my bill like in Philippines. So I need just to worry myself how to recover. I need to focus with that. And I'm so grateful about it. So somehow it helps to be positive. And one thing I realized during dialysis is that I'm only thinking that I'm going to watch a cinema. Because later you will see dialysis has its own TV for one patient. And you can watch a lot of channel.
And that's why we don't go to the movie theater too much, because our minds are too much of being in dialysis.
Yeah. Because now if we watch movie...
Except for popcorn.
Yeah. Now if we will watch movie, I feel like I'm in dialysis. Or we will watch in the cinema theater.
And she doesn't sit still to watch it. The only time she sits still is in dialysis to watch a movie. That's it. Here at home? Nah, she's bouncing all over the place. Like ADD or something. I don't know.
Oi. Okay, today guys, this is actually one of the important vlog or important topic that I'm sharing in my vlog, because I'm gradually opening up myself if who really am I, what is the real core of my life. So as I told you in my introductory message for my vlog, that I'm doing vlog because I want you guys to inspire of all what I experience, and I hope you are taking lessons and tips of everything what I shared to you guys.
Yeah, and ladies and gentlemen, I may be making a lot of jokes during this video clip, but it is serious business. What Pinky goes through is very, very painful every time, and it's just to relieve the symptoms of her condition. It's not a treatment, and hopefully soon she'll be able to get a new kidney and be able to live a little bit longer, because it really is a life-threatening situation. So with her sharing this, I was making jokes just to make her feel more comfortable about sharing, and the fact that I am supporting her as much as possible with this, because this is very important. Yes, I'm getting teary-eyed.
You're going to cry, baby. I'm gonna cry, baby. Don't cry. Don't cry. See, he's very funny, but at the same time, he's very emotional. So, in few minutes, we're heading to dialysis. Because today is Saturday, so my decision, it starts at 6. So 6 to 10.
With permission of the nurse there, I'm going to be taking the video of her going through her dialysis. And you can see firsthand what she's talking about and what it takes to continue her life for a while. Now she's going to cry.
Where are you going?
Taking my wife to go get her blood taken out of and put back in.
It's like selling in a pawn shop and put it back?
Yeah. They use it for something and they put it back. And some kind of pajama bottom.
So, we're heading to a dialysis center now. And most of the time I'm wearing only some very comfy clothes, because I will just lie down and sleep for 4 hours.
Yeah, she gets the nap for 4 hours while the blood's coming out of her and back in her.
Yeah.
We'll see. You'll see it. I'll show it to you.
Yes. So we're heading to dialysis center now.
It's right next to the big building right there, which is the Marriott, which mm-hmm. one of my friends and co-workers used to stay at all the time. Mr. Wayne Russell in the house.
Hi, Wayne. We miss you here, Wayne.
We do miss you, buddy.
Thank you. We are in my room. This is where we do my dialysis. This is the machine. And in my very comfortable bed, and BG is with me, and we have TV. Each patient has its own TV. We will connect our headset over there, and we have our own sink. And that's it. I'm always wearing diaper when I do dialysis, and this is my jacket uniform for my dialysis, because I don't want the big peep cuff will touch on my burly skin in my arm. Yeah, Asha, she's from India, and she's been with me since day one of my dialysis, and she's very nice. very polite and very gentle, and she's taking care of me all the time. And she is now in her second baby. When I met her, she doesn't have baby yet.
Put in new place. Fine.
That's nice. Actually, can you scratch more?
You want to scratch?
Yeah. Down, down. Yeah.
Enough, enough. Lift your hand.
She's such a.
Sure, this is peritoneal hemodialysis.
This is
hemodialysis. Oh, hemodialysis. I always confuse with that.
Peritoneal is
in the tummy. Yeah. One second. I feel itchy. I have gone.
Where is it here?
No, in my face.
Okay, I'll put it here. Okay. Ready, one, two. Done. Pain?
A little bit. See guys, this is the needle I'm always suffering every other day, 3 times in a week. It's a huge needle. How's your baby?
Fine.
Is it kicking a lot?
Scan next week.
Oh.
Your daughter?
She's fine.
Thanks, Dad.
In bed.
She's able to go out now?
No, we are not taking her son.
Oh, you are not allowing her. I'm hooked up now, and this session will take 4 hours.
Give you injection, okay?
The good thing in this facility, when it comes to their dialysis, because they are only using one dialyzer for one patient, of course. It's only single use.
Can
not like.
Charlie?
Yeah. Thank you, Asha.
Bye. Welcome. Okay.
Okay.
I'm not going anywhere.
As if you are not coming back.
The way sitting we sit. In front of you.
Yeah. And then, as I've told you, here it's only one time use of dialyzer. And everything is free here as long as you have insurance. This is the good thing. And the bed is very comfortable. We have our own privacy. As you can see around. Yeah, everything is covered. So if I have, if Biji is here or my cousin here is here, they have a chair to sit on. But Biji is bringing his own comfortable chair so he can sleep. So he can sleep because he's quite tall and he felt bad in his back and his butt when he kept sitting on that.
All right, we're going to lower you down a bit here.
And they are also serving us snacks.
Oh, snacks.
In the middle of, or after an hour, the snacks will arrive that designed only for us dialysis patients.
So T-bone steak and potatoes? No. So we're gonna,
it's not a meal, baby, it's just a snack.
We're going to swing over here. We'll show you what the dialysis machine actually does. So as you can see, artery and vein is connected with tubing. It goes up into this machine here. And that becomes her heart right there. That's what's pumping the blood through her system. It goes actually up into this filtration system. That's what she meant by a
dialyzer.
A dialyzer. That's the dialyzer. It's only one time use for per patient. And once it goes through this filter system, and it goes through also a salt filtration system, then it goes back into her body, all cleaned out of bad stuff, creatinine.
He is now in his most comfortable position.
Got my chair up. Got my mask off. Got my feet up. Where is the...
And where's your headset, baby?
Oh, headsets are right here.
We have two headsets.
We split it up so that we can both have headsets.
Mm-hmm. It's like we are in an airplane. It's like we are in airplane.
Yeah, kind of like an airplane. Our noise canceling headset.
This is me. Sometimes I'm sleeping the whole session, but sometimes if I'm hooked up with a nice movie, I cannot sleep. I may fall asleep like 30 or 1 hour before it will finish. We're watching this movie. It's a Mission Impossible 3 out 2. Didn't make it.
So this is her normal look during dialysis. She stays very still and just sleeps through. It helps pass the time for her, but for me, I'm still here watching movies for 4 hours because I can't sleep in this chair most of the time. But yeah, there she is, just snoozing away. So this is how we normally are. Watching the TV, holding hands while she's there. Pretty cool, huh?
So guys, I wake up
because I feel hungry, and I asked PG to buy food outside because I don't like the food that they are giving on me. That's a bad thing somehow, because this food is repeated every time I'm doing dialysis. If it, like, for example, Saturday, I have like this. My food every Saturday. And I'm tired of eating that food. So when BG is around, I can have a choices. Thank you, baby, for loving me and taking care of me. So I'm waiting. I'm really hungry. I don't know. We eat pizza this afternoon, and suddenly I woke up, I feel hungry. So what you got?
So, so I went to Texas Chicken because you said they had rice. And when I asked the lady for Texas rice, she thought I said two fries.
Two fries?
Two fries instead of Texas rice. And my American, Texas rice, two fries. So I got two fries and Texas rice.
Wow.
Texas chicken tenders.
Oh, baby.
The bowl of Texas rice.
Mm-hmm.
It has, looks like it's got chicken pieces in it. So. Two orders of fries. Tea.
Wow.
Soda tea.
Thank you, baby. Mm-hmm. Thank you, baby. And we'll eat.
Ta-da, with you over there.
We're eating now.
Having Texas chicken.
I like it. What are we eating? That's it, guys. I'm cheating, guys. Don't follow me. But chicken is good for dialysis patient. All the time, I need to eat chicken 4 times in a week. And only sometimes, like 2 times in a week for beef and chicken. No, beef and fish, because they are highly source of phosphorus, and phosphorus is not good for my body.
So, 8:20, we should probably take a nap now. We've got our food, we had our movie. Now it's time for a nap.
I'll try maybe later after 30 minutes because I just eat. I'm still full.
What, like you gonna go run a marathon right now while you're eating?
Mm-hmm.
You gonna go run a marathon right now before you taking a nap or what?
Just resting.
Well, okay. All right.
We're done. We are landed.
We've landed.
We arrived. I didn't sleep the whole dialysis. I was watching a movie. Don't press your if needle is still there. Thank you. Don't put too much, I will hold.